Hi, this is Justice, and welcome to the Brush Creator series. In this first overview video, we're going to be talking about how to save, delete, clone your brushes, as well as share them. And then I'll talk about the user interface for the Brush Creator. What are the different sections and what are they about? Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at this context menu here. So if we change something, let's go over here to stroke. We're going to increase this. You'll notice that these icons right here become active, they're no longer grayed out. Reset brush changes, which is Control Shift H. Save changes as default, which is Control Shift B. And save as a new brush preset, Control Shift P. These three options can be found right over here as well. This leftmost icon, when you tap it, is going to restore back to whatever this brush, Harry 2, was saved at originally. Now if we make a change, and right here we want to save the changes to Harry 2. So Harry 2 is going to be updated. You're going to update the changes here. You're going to revert the changes here. And here you're going to make a new one. You're going to clone Harry 2 into Harry 3. It'll increment by one number. I think a good practice, if you're playing with a brush, you like it, go ahead and copy that brush preset to favorites. It's going to do something very similar to this one. It's going to clone it, but then place it into the favorites brushes where you can easily access all the ones that you've tinkered with. All right, so let's go back to our Harry brush, and we are going to delete this one. We're going to right click and choose remove brush preset. Now, if you've created a brush that you would like to share, right down here is the option to share brushes. You can choose what you're sharing here. You can write a description for others who are searching the brush library on the Rebelle website. You can search to find your brushes. And then this is going to, when you share it, it's going to show you that it's uploading. So you don't have to fill anything out right here. Okay, so let's talk about the different sections of the Brush Creator. This first one, you can see these section titles here. Size, opacity, and spacing. To learn more about this section, watch the Brush Creator video on stroke. Shape, this is going to be what your brush head looks like. So if you tap on the screen, you can see that we have this shape right here. The grain is applying a texture to it, and you can adjust a lot of these properties. Again, I'll have a video on shape and grain. And the paint section is where you can adjust your pressure curves for the brush, when it blends versus when it paints, when it mixes versus blend, whether or not the brush is going to glaze over the top or whether it's going to apply with a normal blending mode. So notice some of these are not available in oils and acrylics, like the rendering. So you want to keep in mind that these are tool specific. You notice that these ones don't have impasto height because this tool does not have impasto height. In the next video, we're going to be talking about how these settings right here for saving, duplicating, and resetting, how these work with these settings right here, save volumes in paint modes, and don't save volumes, because these things are saved and refreshed based off of the Brush Creator settings up here. If you have any questions, put it in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.